This video is on the topic of equilibrium. A reversible reaction will exist in equilibrium in a closed system. A closed system is one in which reactants and products cannot escape. In this example, the sealed container prevents this from happening, and an equilibrium exists between the iodine crystals and iodine vapor. So equilibrium only occurs in a closed system. Let's explore what the term equilibrium means further. Take a reversible reaction in which only the reactants are present initially. As the reaction progresses, the rate of the forward reaction will decrease as the reactants are used up, as shown by the blue line in the graph. The rate of the reverse reaction will increase as the amount of product builds up, as shown by the yellow line. Eventually, the rate of the forward reaction will equal the rate of the reverse reaction. We say that the reaction has reached equilibrium. This means that the reactants are forming the products at the same rate as the products are forming the reactants. So overall, there is no change in the concentration of the reactants and products. We often say that equilibrium is dynamic because of the continuous reactions that are taking place. Make sure that you learn these key characteristics of equilibrium, as these are often asked about in exams. A common misconception is that the concentrations of the reactants and products are the same as each other at equilibrium, as opposed to remaining constant, so make sure you learn this correctly. Most exam questions about equilibrium require you to refer to those three key characteristics of equilibrium that we have just looked at. This is a typical exam question about equilibrium, which is testing your understanding of what is meant by a closed system. There are a number of ways in which you can answer this question, which are all acceptable. So you can say that nothing can enter or leave the reaction. Alternatively, you can say that the reactants and products cannot escape, or the reaction container is sealed. This next question asks you to explain why a reversible reaction may look as if it has gone to completion. This will occur because there is no overall change in the quantities present, even though the reactants are continuously forming the products and the products are continuously forming the reactants. You need to explain why this happens. Your first mark is to state that the forward and reverse reaction occur at the same rate. Remember that the backward reaction can also be referred to as the reverse reaction. The second mark is to state that this means there'll be no change in the concentration or quantities of the reactants and products. This question asks you to show on the graph the time at which equilibrium of a reversible reaction was reached. This is testing both your knowledge of what equilibrium is and your ability to analyse a graph. Look at the axes of the graph to help you understand what it is showing you. The graph is showing you how the concentration of both the reactants and the products change as the reaction progresses. You know that equilibrium, the concentrations of the reactants and the products remain constant, so you need to find the time where their concentrations do not change. This is the point where the curves become horizontal. The best way to mark this would be to use a ruler and draw a vertical line from the point on the curves where they become horizontal down to the x-axis, although you don't need to show the line passing through the reactants and products to gain the mark. A word of caution, students sometimes think this point corresponds to the time at which equilibrium is reached. However, this is the point at which the concentrations of the reactants and products are the same, and as previously mentioned, this is not when equilibrium occurs. It only occurs when the concentrations do not change. In summary, a reversible reaction will exist in equilibrium in a closed system, which is one in which reactants and products cannot escape, such as in a sealed container. At equilibrium, the rate of the forward reaction equals the rate of the reverse reaction, and the concentration of the reactants and products will remain constant. Equilibrium is said to be dynamic, as both forward and reverse reactions are continuously taking place. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.